In this video, I'm doing part two of some Affinity Designer basics. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts, a channel all about helping you design and sell t-shirts online. In this video, I'm going to talk about more Affinity Designer basics. I did a part one earlier. I'll put the link up here for part one, where I went over some of the tools on the left-hand side of Affinity Designer. In this part two, I'm going to do more of those tools on the left side and see how far we get. There's a lot of good tools on this one, so you're going to want to stay all the way till the end, as well as another edition of trend credits. So let's get started. So here we are back on Affinity Designer. I tried to make it just a little bigger so you can see more of the tools. Hopefully this helps. So the last time we were here, we used this vector brush tool. That was the last tool I told you about. The next one right under it is the fill tool. And let me show you what that does. So first we're going to need something to fill. So I'm going to just draw in a square right here. And then go back to the fill tool. And then you can just drag on it like that. And you can see it's filling the shape with two colors. So there's different things that you can do here with the fill tool. There's no fill. There's a solid fill. If we just did, then it's solid white and you can pick a color. We also have linear, which is a linear gradient. So let's pick that. And then the gradient will be, you pick this color first here. So let's pick a red, just so you can see it. And then this color is second. So let's just pick like a yellow so you can see it, the difference. So just do a gradient from the color you pick here to the color here. And you can add multiple colors in here as well. So if you want this to be blue instead in the middle, then you can do that. Nice rainbow color. And you can add as many colors as you want here, here, and you can move them as well. So you can move that and move this and so on. So that's linear gradient. Of course, there's others like elliptical gradient. This is more like a circle. You can see as I pull this down, like a circle kind of gradient. And then you have radial gradient, which is kind of the same. And then you have conical, which looks more like a cone. So let me pull this in here. So this one's kind of a weird one with the colors being on the outside. So you can see that, how it's doing that. And bitmap, this one you actually have to go in and pick a bitmap. So I'm not gonna do that. So the other things that are here are the different contexts. So you have a fill and a stroke. So stroke is the outside of it or the outline. So let me just do another one here. Let me fill this in with just a solid color. So now the stroke here is going to be this big, but I got to color it so you can see it. Let's do the stroke red right now. So you can see here, just the stroke has the gradient from light red or yellow, right, to red. So that's how you do that. And then this just switches it. So it rotates the gradient around a corner. And this one just does it backwards. So red to yellow or yellow to red. And then this one, it just maintains the aspect ratio of it. So when you, so you hit that and you grow the size of the object, it just maintains the same thing. So this fill tool is great for gradients. I use it all the time. So if you want to put any gradients in your artwork, that's the tool you're going to want to use. So the next tool is the transparency tool. So we're going to need a couple of shapes for this one too. So let me just show you right here. Let's just make this one black. Actually, let's do red and yellow because this works really well. So we got that. And then we'll do another shape. Let's just do a circle shape here that is yellow. Okay, so now this yellow shape is above the red shape here. So when I hit this transparency tool, you can see it's kind of like that gradient tool, but it's transparent. it does it not a color, it does it the opacity. So you can change the opacity here. And I hardly use this tool because the opacity is right here, all I need to do is change it there and there. So it's, you could still use the gradient tool, this one right here, the fill tool. And let me show you, let's get out of here. You can get the same effect by doing that and hit this, do that, and then just take this opacity down. So same thing there, but it's just nice that it does it for you. So I hardly use the transparency tool. I mainly use the fill tool when I do want to do something like that. So the next tool is the place image tool right here. So if you click on that, you'll see your desktop or any folder. You can get access to any folder and just pick a picture from there and hit OK and then drop it in right there. And that's all it does. It just places the image from any one of your folders, your desktop or wherever, and your image can rotate and scale and anything like that. I rarely use this because I can just get on my desktop and just drag it in and it does the same thing. So I rarely use this tool, but it's there for you if you need it. The next tool is the vector crop tool right here. And it works really well with images. So I'm going to show you how that works. So click on the vector crop tool and then click on the image and you'll see these handles here to crop it. And you can crop it in or go out. So this is really good if you need a quick mask of your image, just a quick rectangle mask or square mask. This will do really well. So that's how you use that one. Vector crop tool. I don't use it that much because I don't crop things just in a rectangle. I like to mask things out in a shape, but it's there if you need that one too. It's a really quick crop tool. So the next few tools are the shape tools. So lots of cool things you can do with these shapes. Let's do the rectangle. If you click on it and hold down shift, you can see it does a perfect square. Width and height are the same. I'm holding down shift as I drag. The other things you can do with this is, so you can do rounded corners here, even though there's a rounded corner tool, rounded rectangle tool, which does the exact same thing. So I'm just going to show you the rounded corners here. But if you wanted this rounded rectangle tool, same thing, same handles, same thing. So the different rectangle, the different corners are rounded corner, straight corner, you can see here, kind of cut off, concave, which is kind of nice, and cut out. And you can move those with this percentage right here like that. So that's cool. So the next shape is the circle ellipse tool. This one's really neat because hold down shift again and make a perfect circle. You can convert to pi. So you got these things, whoops. So you got these handles here, or you can make a donut in the pi, or you can move these handles to make your pi a different shape. You can also hit this angle here, this controls it, these two. Or you can invert it, so if you want it the opposite, so there's that. So that's really cool there. And let me go back, oh, let me just make another circle here. You also have the convert to donut. So if you need a donut shape, bigger or smaller, this kind of changes the inside circle, and this changes like what we were seeing earlier, the pie. So really cool. And of course you can invert it and everything or close it. So the one thing with all these shapes, let me do the rounded rectangle so you can see, you can't move certain, you can't move points within it. So it's just a shape that you can move this and this, but if you want to move specific points, you'll have to convert it to a curve. So there, I converted it to a curve. Now I can move the points on it. And that goes with any of these shapes on here. So all the other shapes are in here, triangle tool. When you click on this, you'll see the whole list. This is the whole list right here. So all those shapes right there are pretty fun. You can try them all out yourself. I'm not going to go through all of them, but they all kind of work the same way as what we saw with the square and the circle. So I really like the heart tool. So let me show you that. it just makes a heart, and that's really convenient for Valentine's Day. And, you know, if you want to put it like that and turn it and maybe duplicate it and maybe duplicate both of these and flip it. You know, you could do a clover really easy, maybe a four leaf, three leaf clover, you know. Space it out like that. So this is really helpful if you need a clover or a heart or any of those kinds of things. Not exactly the clover, but you know what I mean. You can use these shapes to make other shapes. So those are all the shape tools out there. Have fun with those. Play around with those and see what you can make with those shapes. Those shapes are really powerful, so you don't have to draw them yourself with the pen tool. So the next tool is the color picker tool, and it's pretty much the same as this color picker tool here. So if I had this color and I wanted to make another one, but this one was black, but I wanted to make it this same red, I would click on this object, then the color picker tool, and then that's how you would do it. So real simple. You can do the same thing with the color here. So if I did this and pick the color here and went like that and then hit this, it would do the same thing. So that's how you can pick a color with the color picker tool, either here or over here with the color palette. The next thing here is the view tool. So basically, if I click on this hand, I can move everything around. So I'm moving my artboard around everywhere. So I don't use this very much because I can just slide and go up and down this way without it. So I don't know how good this one is, but it's there, you can use it. I almost never use that tool. And the last thing is zoom. So let's pull in that beach again. So if I wanted to zoom, I just click, 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 click like that, and that would zoom. Or I could hold down option and unzoom or go back. So zoom, 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 option, click. So I don't use that either because I have my trackpad and I can just zoom in and zoom out and zoom in and zoom out real quick with the two finger pinch and pull. So I hardly use that one. So those are all the tools on the left side. Congratulations. You know how all of those work. For my next video, I'll probably talk about all these tools up here. There's a lot of them and the different palettes and all these things. There's still a lot more to learn, but you got the basics. So now that you know how all these tools work, try it out on your Affinity Designer and see how it goes. Maybe you'll find other things that I haven't taught you. Let me know in the comments what else you want to learn in Affinity Designer. Thanks so much for watching this video, and your reward is another edition of Trend Credits. Thanks for joining me on this Trend Credit. Here is your Trend 2021 Summer Re-Education Camp shirt. So you can see here, the low BSRs, 352, 205, 99,000, 289,000. So it just goes on and on. Think of your own idea for this. Maybe it doesn't say 2021 summer camp. Maybe it doesn't say re-education camp, but this is just the outdoor 2021 outdoor camping kind of niche. So think of different ways to do that. Here in Merch Informer, it is getting an A, so you know it's good. Don't forget, I have a link in the description for Merch Informer. Lots of good things here, including the competition checker and product search and all this cool stuff, as well as Merch Informer graphics, which they release every month. So 2021 Summer Re-Education Camp shirt. Make sure to do this in your own style. Have fun with this one. I think it will be a great hit. It is trending right now, so you want to jump on this one. Thanks so much for watching this video. And again, let me know in the comments what other things you want me to show on Affinity Designer, what kind of tips and tricks for Affinity Designer that you want to know on there. I'll make it on the next Affinity Designer video, part 3. And don't forget to like and subscribe. If this video gave you value, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed already, hit that subscribe button. Thanks so much for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.